You.
All right, thanks so much, Adam. Well, it's time for another edition of Camp California. These are so fun, and this morning we're uncovering ghost towns. Take a look at the map. There are quite a few in the Golden State.
Okay, so we're going to begin with China Camp in Marin. Chinese immigrants settled there as early as the 1870s. It became known for fishing instead of mining.
Next up is Bodie, where more than 10,000 people came to try to strike it rich back in the day. The Bodie Butte mine produced over 25 million in gold and silver.
Volcano, also known as a ghost town in the Golden State. This town, by the way, had a reputation for violence, but it soon became a place of elegance due to the delicate architecture.
And last but not least, there's also Genoa. Much of the town burned in the fire of 1910, but there is still plenty to see and do. So that's your little history lesson we gave you. And the ghost town known for gold is right in Coloma.
And that's where we find Fox 40's Pedro Vera to tell us more about the history behind it all. Hey, Pedro, good morning.
Yeah, I'm so excited to be out here. Let me tell you, so Diana Kelly with Camp California, she's been trying to get me out in the field for some time. We do these segments all the time.
And
you
can
say, I'm going to get you out there one day, and here I am in Coloma.
I know, I'm so excited to have you out here in the wilderness, finally.
You know, it's because gold. You said there's gold, so I had to rush here.
That's what it took to get you out here?
That's what it took to get me here.
Well, today we are out in Coloma, the very first site that gold was discovered in the West. And we are going to be panning over here to Jerry from California State Parks, who's going to give us some information on some of the unique features of Coloma and why people came here.
And one of them is right here behind us, this building. Tell us about this building here and why it's so unique.
This is Beckert's Gun Shop. It is one of the oldest buildings that is still standing here in Coloma. It was built in 1852 and used by a man named Frank Beckert as a gun shop. He came out here in 1849 and quickly decided that gold panning wasn't for him. And so he started selling guns and fixing guns and made a whole lot more money doing that than he would have ever made panning for gold.
And panning for gold is still something that's done. And of course, that's what spurred the, like you said, the mass migration to this area. Right here behind us, too, you host a lot of kids. Kids still come here and pan for gold, right?
Yes, we have gold panning here every day on the hour. We also host, in mostly during the spring, thousands of fourth graders from all over California. They come here to learn about the gold rush and to pan and do some of our other school programs. We have a wagons program and a poke making program.
Thousands of kids.
Thousands of kids.
Probably you at home watching right now, you probably took a class trip out here to Coloma at some time to check it out. And that building over there in the distance, what is that? Because that has some history too, right?
Yes, those two stone buildings over there were built in around 1856 by a man named Jonas Wilder, and they were leased to the Chinese. That was Coloma's Chinatown down there. And in the 1860s, about a third of the population of Coloma was actually Chinese.
Oh, nice. So a big Chinese influence here in the community. So if you're looking for more information on those ghost towns or a historic town just like this one, where do you go?
Camp-California.com.
It's that easy. See how easy that was, guys? I'm going to continue hanging out here, learning more about Coloma. Maybe I'll go pan for gold. I need to buy a new car, so I'm going to go get rich. So I'll send it back to you.
Pedro and his car. You're funny.
Bring
no, you've got
this.
Bring
some gold back. That'd be fun.
Yeah.
What a fun experience just getting to explore our own backyard.
I know, I just love Camp California just because it helps you as parents find places you can take your kids during the summer to learn more about the history. And even as we just heard too, I mean, it wasn't just gold mining. People got really creative to create business, and that's how, you know, a lot of our California industry was created after that. So
that's
I just love it. I'm a history major, so I'm nerding out.
Some of those places are haunted too, by the way. I'm gonna pick Pedro's brain about that later in the show. It's 8:40.